Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In the previous unit, you learned a lot about factoring polynomials, especially second-degree polynomials, also known as quadratics. In this unit, we'll look even deeper into quadratic functions, starting with the special shape their graphs make, the parabola. By the end of this lesson, you will be able to understand and be able to describe the basic features of parabolas. In the process, you'll learn about the symmetry of parabolas. We'll also learn about a parabola's vertex and how it's special. And finally, you'll learn about the two forms that parabolas can take. This is a parabola. The first thing you probably notice right off the bat is that it's symmetrical. Every parabola has a vertical line of symmetry. In this case, that line of symmetry is at x equals negative 2. As basic as this knowledge is, it helps a lot. If we know that 2 units from the line of symmetry, the function has an output of 0, that isn't just for one side. It's true for both sides of the lines of symmetry. The biggest use for this knowledge is when graphing parabolas. We only have to calculate points on one side of the line of symmetry, because once we find those points, the other side is a mirror image. The second thing to know is that because every parabola has a side going down and a side going up, there is always a maximum or minimum point. That point is called the vertex, and it also just happens to be on the line of symmetry. The vertex can typically be seen as the center of the graph. The other points are symmetrical around it. Just like with the line of symmetry, we can use this to our advantage. If you know that an x-intercept is 2 units to the right of the vertex, we know there has to be another one 2 units to the left. We can also use symmetrical points to find the vertex's location. If we know that these 2 points have the same output, then the vertex has to be in the middle of them, somewhere on the line of symmetry. And if we also happen to know that there's a minimum at -4, that tells us where the vertex is, because the vertex is both on the line of symmetry and a minimum or maximum. A parabola has x-intercepts at -1 and 3. It has a maximum at 3. Where is its vertex? We've been told where the x-intercepts are, at -1 and 3. So that means the line of symmetry is in the middle, and that the vertex is somewhere on that line of symmetry. We also know that the only maximum on a parabola is its vertex, so the vertex must be somewhere at y equals 3. The vertex is on both of these lines, and there's only one such point at 1, 3. Finally, there are 2 forms parabolas can take. Right side up or upside down. Do you remember the transformation that flips a graph upside down? To reflect a regular parabola upside down, you make the leading coefficient negative. That's it. That's the only difference. A right side up parabola has a positive leading coefficient, and an upside down parabola has a negative coefficient. In fact, if you take a regular quadratic function and multiply it by -1, that's all it takes to flip it over. Would this function have a minimum or a maximum? If we look closely, it has a negative leading coefficient, which means it will create an upside down parabola. There will be a maximum. For this function, the leading coefficient is positive. So the parabola would be right side up, and it would have a minimum. Now you understand what a parabola is and how to describe its features. But what use is that? Well, in the next video, we're going to look at some parabolas representing real-world scenarios and use these new terms to describe and analyze what the graphs are telling us. See you then!